Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the AEPi Shabbat D'var series. My name is Brother Brett Brody of Sigma Alpha. Thank you to our brothers and friends who are tuning in with us from across the world. As we close off the week and welcome the Sabbath, we are thrilled to have a special guest for you all, Brother Rabbi Menes Kogen of Sigma Alpha. Rabbi Menes Kogen was born in Buenos Aires, Argentina. He received his rabbinical ordination from the Seminario Rabbinico Latino Americano in Buenos Aires. Rabbi Kogen serves as the spiritual leader of Hillcrest Jewish Center in Fresh Meadows, New York, where he lives with his wife, Sylvia, and their three children, Daniela, Ilian, and Abby. Hillcrest Jewish Center is a traditional egalitarian and participatory congregation serving 350 families in Eastern Queens.
Hi, everybody. And thank you, Brett, and thank you, brothers, for inviting me. This is my first experience doing sharing with you words of Torah with my brothers at AEPi. I hope you find it meaningful. As Brett explained, this accent is from Argentina. And I have two choices, to talk about the Torah portion by Gra or to talk about Pesach, which will begin in only 8 days. So let me see if I can connect them very, very quickly. I only have a few minutes. So Vayikra, the first Torah portion in the book of Leviticus, is all about sacrifice. It's actually a very dry Torah portion in general, with details on all kinds of sacrifices and different ways to come closer to God through traditional offerings that in ancient times were of animals. And many times the rabbis referred to the sacrifices as the food of the altar. Basically, you feed the altar with food. We don't do sacrifices already for many years, but I want to talk to you a little about this idea of food. And food is very, very important in Pesach. And I want to share with you an idea that I learned from my youngest daughter. And if you are familiar with the Pesach Haggadah, you don't have to know the entire Pesach Haggadah, but there is one part that I think that everybody should know. And it goes like this. I'm going just to put it here. Rabban Gamliel used to say, whoever has not explained the following three things on Pesach, on Passover, has not fulfilled his duty. And the three things are Pesach, Matzah, and Maror. So I'm sure even if you went to Hebrew school or to Sunday school, you are familiar with these words, Pesach, Matzah, and Maror. And the Gemara is going to ask, what is each of them? So Pesach, Passover, is the sacrifice that our ancestors ate in Egypt first, and then when the temple existed, and remind us that God passed over the houses of the Egyptians when he smote the firstborn in Egypt. And we were saved, you know, the story with marking the doors, God passed over, that's the name of the holiday, and this was the name of the sacrifice. So this is Passover, Pesach. Matzah, we eat matzah because the rabbis, actually the Torah explains to us that the dough didn't have time to rise, and that's why we eat the unleavened bread in Pesach. And maror, bitter herbs, we eat bitter herbs to remind us of the bitterness that our ancestors suffered in the land of Egypt. And all that is in the Haggadah. And even if you keep and you do a 5-minute seder in which you just tell the basic story, which actually you can say, if someone asks you, no, tell me what is this holiday about, you can say, we were slaves to Pharaoh in Egypt, and God took us from there, and we became free. And the main three ideas of Pesach can be symbolized in Pesach, Matzah, and Maror, which is interesting because the three most important concepts of Pesach are not liberty, freedom, and fulfillment. They are not abstract concepts, but they're all food items. Pesach used to be meat, a sacrifice. Matzah is the bread and unleavened bread, and maror is bitter herb. So why are these three items so important, and what can they teach us? And that's what I want to share with you. So let's talk about Pesach. The sacrifice of Pesach reminds us that we were slaves, and a minute later, we were free. Many times we go through life through very, very difficult moments. And I don't know if you are going through difficult moments, but I did go through difficult moments in life. Some people are depressed, some people are down, and they have dealing with many challenges. And they ask themselves, when is this going to be over? Can this be over? Will I feel better eventually? And the story of Pesach tells us that there is hope and that things can change, actually. And sometimes can change, you know, for the better, hopefully, quicker than what we think. And this is the idea of Passover. You know, you can pass from a, I would say, gloomy present to a brighter future. Matzah is also very, very important, because we can ask the question, why couldn't we wait until the bread rose and was maybe tastier or you know, a little fluffier? Or, you know, the matzah may be important, but it's not so tasty, like, you know, a nice baguette. And the matzah teaches us that in life you need to prioritize, that in life you cannot wait sometimes. Sometimes when you have the opportunity to be free, you cannot say, you know, I want freedom, but I also want a fluffy bread. You need to choose. And in life, always, we will have to choose. And it's very important to know how to choose and to choose well. And in this case, freedom, of course, is more important than the comfort of a tastier bread. And our ancestors chose with wisdom, and we should choose with wisdom as well. And maror, I think that reminds us to put things in perspective. Many times we complain about, oh, this is, you know, very bitter, or my computer doesn't work, or I have been without internet for 2 hours. You know, I know it's annoying. I know it's really very problematic. You know, I couldn't connect with my Netflix account. Really, it's not great. But we need to put things in perspective. And I think maror reminds us that our ancestors were slaves in Egypt, that really didn't have internet, didn't have Netflix, didn't have many of the comforts that we have. And all they wanted is to be free and to be able to worship Hashem the way they wanted, without anybody telling them what to do and how to do things. And sometimes maror can put things in perspective. When we remember the bitterness of our ancestors, is another way to remember all the blessings that we have. So I think my time is up, and I want to wish all of you Shabbat Shalom. I want to wish you a happy Pesach, and only good things to all of you. And thank you so much for inviting me. And Brett, I pass it with you.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Brother Rabbi Kogen, for that wonderful d'var. I especially like what you said about maror. Thank you again to all our brothers and friends from across the world for tuning in. Be sure to check out our AEPi Connect page and calendar at AEPi.org for future events. Good Shabbos, everyone.